I think that it's partially true. Of course, everyone is laying off because of the startup landscape trend that we see, right? So the company is becoming more efficient in this hard economic situation. But again, the rise of LLMs, I do believe that it impacted who got laid off quite a lot, because for example, of course, we are talking about LLM use cases that LLMs can solve, and use cases that, let's call them now, classic machine learning models can solve, right? And they will always remain, like use cases that require very high throughput in the very fast speeds, like ranking systems and similar. But then we have the entire field of NLP, right? So I think that NLP, classic NLP is dead, right? Most likely. Most of the use cases will be solved by LLMs. And there are a lot of researchers, I think, and data scientists who tried to solve NLP use cases for companies, and LLMs came and that's it. You don't need like classical NLP models almost anymore, right? Because LLMs can solve most of it, and we are getting cheaper. Like even the weakest LLMs, like not talking about GPT-4, like GPT-3.5 is good enough and better at solving these problems than classic NLP models, right? So I think that had a big impact also on who got laid off. I think these problems are now a lot less researchy because engineers can solve them, right? Engineers can start plugging in LLMs with documents and summarizing these documents, and or extracting named entities from a document. You don't need a data scientist there anymore. As well, we also spoke, I remember, in one of our podcast episodes about how we believe data scientists have to evolve. So either we become more of a business BI analysts, so closer to analytics, or becoming machine learning engineers. And I still think that is the case. But then probably we'll have also engineers who would be just engineers and not labeled machine learning engineers, who can also solve machine learning related problems.
Do you see like a case where, let's say there is, NLP problem that is very important from production use case? It is on production. Mm-hmm.
So it depends.
It was built by data scientists and is operated. It is. Definitely would try to figure out whether it's what you can do with large language models to replace it or improve it. But I would assume that the task would be given in such case, like to improve it, there is testing around it to data scientists first. That's why so it is one case. Second case, yes, like it is not on production. They are playing, they are trying to figure out what they can get. It is still kind of POC research project. This, I think it is very likely to be killed, like if they spend half a year or a year already and results are not so great. And imagine that in 2 weeks there is some software engineer intern who came up with something equally or more promising. This is very tempting to kill this POC, traditional NLP project. But in those two examples, I think that the main thing is whether it's on production or not, whether it's used or not.
It really depends on what you label production, right? If you're requiring these instant answers from your model, then of course not. But there are just use cases where you summarize documents, you do some sentiment analysis, you extract things from text, like named entities, etc. So these are very legit production use cases, I think, that a lot of companies rely on to optimize their work day to day. It's not user facing. It's usually internal and maybe cutting other costs significantly. But these are, in my mind, production use cases. And I do believe that companies have spent a lot of money on data scientists who were building these solutions for the companies to become more efficient in their day-to-day operations. At least that, and I know that it's the case. So some of them actually are, like some of these remain in POC forever. I guess now it has come to an end because no one will be POCing for a lot of money just to not get any result.
I think, Aurimas, that maybe what you are saying is something that we will see, but I just, for me, it was hard to believe that it would happen for production use cases so quickly that, you know, you have a traditional model that's what works. Mm-hmm. You're dismissing data science team part of the data science team, mm-hmm. because you hope you will be able to do the same or better with LLM. Mm-hmm. I think eventually we can see this trend, but when we are discussing the layoffs of this year, I think.
So you're saying it's too early, basically.
Yes, I'm talking. Maybe there are cases like that, but I think that if we try to assign weights, the weights would be around global economics needs about efficiency and cut the POC projects that are more around, you know, trying to find an edge, but not proven to be delivering value. And I would be, I don't have data, but I would be interested to see, maybe some people can add some points in the comments to see the statistics around layoffs.